just working on those 12 bars, right, making them happen. And he just did it. Right? He just did it.
To another sold out night at the Bell Vendors! All right, so I can tell that we have some new people in here. So I just want to tell you what our protocol is. When I say that, you applaud like this is the best jazz that you can get sandwiched between a sub shop and a Brazilian wax salon. Let's try it again. Welcome to another sold out night at the Velvet Notes! The Velvet Notes is a place you can see and hear world class musicians in a setting that's as intimate and as comfortable as your very own living room. We give you a chance to get to know the musicians here and to hear the music the way that it was meant to be heard. The Velvet Note is a listening room. We had our acoustics designed by a protege of the Hollywood director George Lucas under his guidance to be the highest quality, unenhanced sound available today. And we're so pleased tonight to welcome someone who was on my short list when we transformed this space from a powder blue yogurt shop to the jazz destination that it is today. He plays really hard to get, but Cyrus Chestnut is an extraordinary name in jazz, and he's got the chops to back it up. He graduated from the Peabody Institute in Baltimore, followed by the prestigious Berklee School of Music. He has toured the world as such a versatile and fun pianist. He has released several albums, and tonight he travels with two of the very best in the business, my friend Curtis Lundy, who he met while playing as part of a Betty Carter quartet, and also Montez Coleman, who I'm just getting to know, who has performed most recently in his career with the McCoy Tyner Band. And so I just want you to know that any one of these guys could be commanding the stage here tonight under their own headline. The fact that you have them all together is like Christmas and New Year's and your birthday all put together. So put your hands together for the Cyrus Chestnut Trio!
Thank you. Curtis Lundy. Curtis Lundy. On drums, Mr. Montez Coleman. Okay. And the music is and the music is out and about and it is going and going and going. You heard tonight's interpretation of Have You Met Miss Jones? And the reason why I say tonight's interpretation, because that's what happened tonight. If you're here to hear repertory renditions of things 20, 30, 40, 50 years ago, you're in the wrong place. Get your money back. I believe in playing the music for now. You know, we stand on history, but we push toward the future. That's what the music requires. And if we are going to deal strictly, if we are going to honor improvisation, which I like to think of as composition at a rapid pace with no erasers. Hey, y'all got it, all right. Then the music must be for now in the moment. So yes, we do think. But we're call us spontaneous thinkers. Yeah, that sounds good. Yeah. Before that, you heard again tonight's interpretation of a piece that you might recognize from the Lionel Richie songbook. We did not play it in the Lionel Richie way. You don't want us to play it in the Lionel Richie way. You didn't pay to come here to see us play it in the Lionel Richie way. So we hope that you enjoyed Hello. And we started out with Hank Mobley composition entitled This I Dig of You. I think I'd like to slow it down, if that's be all right with you. All right. Here's, how about a little Moby? We hope you enjoy Polka Dots and Moonbeams.
Thank you. Thank you.
Your self-discipline to only wear your tiara on your birthday. If I had a tiara, who knows? Thank you so much for coming out. Who's playing here tomorrow night?
Larry Carlton,
yeah! That is incredible that we have Cyrus Chestnut and Larry Carlton in the same weekend here. So if you have those tickets, we'll see you again this weekend. If you don't, I'm so sorry. Maybe next time. This is a great year for us. We're also welcoming Steve and Sasha Mazikowski this month. Next month we have Pat Martino.
Yeah.
And yeah, as of today, we have Joey DeFrancesco coming.
Very
soon. So take a look at thevelvetnote.com. It'll show you all of our upcoming shows. Please give us a chance to entertain you again sometime very soon. This is what we love to do, which is to bring you closer to artists who inspire you, closer to each other, and closer to the song that's in your heart. Come back and see us again soon, can I?
I'm so tired.
Velvet Notes, a place where you can see and hear world-class musicians in a setting that's as intimate and as comfortable as your very own living room. We give you a chance to get to know the musicians here, and also to hear the music the way that it was meant to be heard. The Velvet Note is a listening room, and we had our acoustics designed by a protege of the Hollywood director George Lucas, under his guidance, to be the highest quality, unenhanced sound available today. We have been here 4 years and 6 months. And Downbeat Magazine just notified me for the third consecutive year, we are noted as one of the best jazz clubs worldwide. I want to give a couple of acknowledgments, otherwise known as shout outs. Happy birthday, Martina.
All right.
Raise your hand so they know who you are. Come on, man. Please come back sometime. I also want to give a shout out to Tony Wasluski of Hot Shoe Records, holding the mantle of great jazz. Raise your hand so they know who you are. With several award-winning artists on his roster this year. Way to put that out there. Alrighty, so can I just say, we got Cyrus Chestnut! Yeah. Okay, so when I was transforming this place from a powder blue yogurt shop to this, I had a short list of people I'd like to have here. And making that short list was Cyrus Chestnut. Cyrus was educated first at the Peabody Institute in, does anybody know where that is?
Baltimore.
Who said Baltimore? Yes, thank you, thank you. And then the prestigious Berklee School of Music. Where's that? Anybody know?
Boston.
Okay, good. All right, you guys are with me. And Cyrus has just had an incredible career thus far. He's still a young man, but great career. Not only releasing albums, but also touring with all kinds of folks. He has several albums under his own name, but also a collaborative effort of Vince Garibaldi's Christmas, Charlie Brown Christmas. And I mention that because that's one of my absolute favorite things to listen to during this season. But beyond that, there were two gentlemen who were here in the first show who have been here for, I would like to say, most of our shows. And they both said independently, this is one of the best shows I've ever seen. This is one of the best. And you're gonna know immediately why that is. The freshness, the improvisation, the real understanding of what great jazz is, but a willingness to cast it all anew. On the stage with Cyrus is Curtis Lundy, who, Curtis Lundy. Great bassist. Shared a place on the stage with the Betty Carter Trio. They played together, that's how they met each other. And then Montez Coleman from the McCoy Tyner Band. Yeah. So what I want you to know is that any of these gents could be commanding his own show tonight. You have them all together. It's like having a Sunday on your birthday, which is also New Year's Eve. Put your hands together for the Cyrus Chestnut Trio!
talking out of the way so that once the music starts, you just let it roll. You're in for an original performance. The notes that we're about to play, we have not played before. We believe in improvisation, as I said in our earlier show. I like to think of improvisation as composition at a very rapid pace with no erasers, spontaneous thought. So some people might think, oh, you're just playing anything. Well, we're thinking about things right in the moment, and we react in the moment, ultimately to send you away feeling a little bit better than when you arrived. We hope that you achieve that. So, let me take a second to introduce the band, if that's cool.
Hey, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, on acoustic bass, Mr. Curtis Lundy. On drums, Mr. Montez Coleman. From the pen of composer Jimmy Van Heusen, we'd like to start off with one of his compositions, I've Never Been in Love Before. We hope that you enjoy it, and thank you for coming, and here we go. Thank you.
We'll be right back. Thank you. Thank you. He actually signed the lead sheet for me.
composition's entitled Two Heartbeats. I'd like to tell you the story. I recently recorded it with Curtis and Victor Lewis. And I was sitting down trying to play all of this hip stuff, you know, for a production. And Curtis stopped me and said, "Say, man, you don't have to do all of that." I'm like, "What do you mean?" All you got to do is go, do your dot, do the wee. And I looked at him in disbelief. I said, "Really? Yeah, just go, do your dot, do the wee, and we got you." I didn't believe. I'm like, "Really? Just do it, man." So I said, "Okay. Do your dot, do the wee, bang." I was like, "Oh, okay, so that's how it's supposed to go." So we like to do two heartbeats for you with the this, way.
Thank you.
Jazz tradition, so it's really fun to talk to them. Make sure you let them know how much we appreciate them coming out here to the technology capital of the South, and would love to also have them back. So who knows who's here tomorrow night?
Oh my God,
Larry Carlton, 19-time Grammy winner, Grammy nominee, Larry Carlton. Yes, getting on a bus from Nashville, come on down. So we're really happy that that's happening. So stay tuned to velvetnote.com. You'll see all of our upcoming shows. This was a big one, and I am so happy you were here to join us. What an incredible talent we had tonight. This is what we love to do, which is to bring you closer to artists who inspire you, and closer to each other, but mostly closer to the song that's in your heart. Come back and see us again soon. Good night.
Thank you.
Yeah.